I will explain a little bit about current meter. There are two types of current meter. Number one is price type AA current meter, which is suitable for canals where the depth is more than 1.5 feet and above. And another current meter is pygmy current meter, which is in my hand. It is smaller than that one, and it is suitable for velocity measurement in water courses and unlined channel and even line channels where the depth is from 0.3 feet to 1.5 feet and above. This is headphone through which we will record the clicks when one revolution is completed by the current meter. This is battery and this is wire. The yellow end of this wire will be connected to this battery, and the blue end of this wire will be connected to the current meter. This is a stopwatch through which we will record the time in seconds. And here, this is rating table, which is provided by the manufacturer, and it is given in feet per second, and as well as the velocity is given in meter per second. So as we are recording our all measurements in feet, so we will use the velocity in feet per second. Here, if you see here, there are two columns. One is time in second, and another one is revolution. These columns are related to revolution, and this column related to time in second. This is wedding rod, and it is graduated into inches. This is 4 feet long wedding rod, and this is the holder where we fix our current meter. And 1 foot is divided into 10 equal parts. This 1 foot is different from the normal scale as we are using in our measurement, because here each section is equal to 1/10 feet of this rod. This double line shows 1/2 feet, and here 1 foot, 1.5 feet, 2 feet, and so on. On this rod, on the basis of the depth of flow in the canal or the miner or the water course, we will adjust our current meter depth accordingly. This is base plate. This base plate is provided because as an earthen canal, if the rod is pointed, definitely it will penetrate into the bed of the channel. So as this is wider, so it will not penetrate inside the bed of the channel. So these are the all accessories which we will use. So now we will proceed towards the discharge measurement in miner through current meter. Today I am going to demonstrate the procedure of discharge measurement through current meter. So for this, I am here at miner, which is off-taking from main canal. I have inserted two wooden pegs at left bank and right bank of the miner, and a tag line is stretched across the cross section of this miner, and ribbons are tied at a distance of 1 foot wide from each other. The first ribbon on the tag line is aligned with the edge of the water, which is in contact with the bank of the miner. Now I am going to start measurement. First of all, I will measure the depth of water. It is 2.8. Here current meter will not work properly. This pygmy current meter would start working from 0.3 feet to 1.5 feet effectively. So I will take first reading just far from this second. Now here, this is second point, far from this initial point. First of all, I will measure its depth of flow, and it is here 0.63. Now I will use here 0.6 method, 0.63 multiplied by 0.6. It is 0.378. So I will set my current meter at 0.37 position. Okay. I will keep the direction of this current meter towards the flow direction. The precautions which is necessary to take here, I shouldn't be in front of this flow direction because the flow would pass through easily from the current meter. Now I will start a stopwatch and I will record the clicks. Now here, 50 revolutions or 50 clicks in 53 seconds. This procedure I will repeat at every point, and now I will take now this is last point. So here we can't measure the depth of the water. So here the current meter is not working well because the depth of the water is 0.1 feet. Okay. Now all the data is recorded here and I will complete this calculation in my office.